Testing, 1, 2.
Didn't know today would be your last. That I'd have to say goodbye to you so fast. I'm so numb I can't feel anymore. Praying you just walk back through that door. Tell me that I was only dreaming. You're not really gone as long as I believed. There will be another angel around the throne tonight. Your love lives on inside of me, and I will. Around the throne tonight. You always made my troubles feel so small. You were always there to catch me when I fall. In a world where heroes come and well, God took the only one I'll ever know. So I'll hold you as close as I can, longing for that day when I see your face again. Until around the throne tonight, your love lives on inside of me, and I will hold on tight. It's not my place to question, only God knows why. I'm just jealous of the angels around the throne.
So you're all very welcome to St Mary's as we gather around Cora now this morning. You've had a long journey to get here, and I'm sure it's been a hard journey for you as well. I suppose this last month and the last year or so has been difficult for all of you as well. You've gone through so much. But I just want to say to you that I think that in all of this, you've shown great character. In all of this, you've shown great love. In all of this, you've shown a deep appreciation for both your mum and your dad. And just to say, I'm sure they are both just so proud of you in how you've gone about organizing everything and having the patience to wait until the time was right. And even today, we fulfill one of Cora's wishes by having Kathleen's ashes with us as well, and they'll be buried as well today. So we remember Kathleen as well in our prayers as we gather. So before we enter into the Mass, we're going to bring up some little things that would have been important to Cora. So Caden and Shannon and Leona are going to bring these up.
Thank you.
So just to let you know what they've brought up. They've brought up the hairspray and the nail varnish, the perfume, and there's also a packet of cigarettes and the coffee. All this stuff is wonderment to men, you know. But I saw something on the BBC one night where two families had swapped their lives, if you like, for a week. One was from a very posh place in London, and the other one was from a working class area of Newcastle. But on Friday night, the woman who was in Newcastle from London, she said, "This is the one night I'm cheating," she said. "I am not going out without my makeup," she said. And that there's something about sort of putting on your face, if you like, putting on your best side, wanting to look well. That's just so important for everyone. It talks about trying to show your best self on the outside. In some ways, someone would laugh at this, but in some ways it's like a prayer, you know, because when you sort of make yourself up in that way to show your best when you go out, you become your best self and you feel confident and you feel at home within yourself. So all of that Cora had. And like the pharaohs, she has some of this with her inside as well. So on the day of resurrection, she might stop and have a cigarette first before she goes on into the gates of heaven. So we remember her with love. We gather her to God and give thanks for her life. And we pray now that the Lord will be with you in this time of mourning and this time when what we do now is the greatest act of love. We bring her to Christ, who gave up his life for us so that we will all know eternal life. That's our hope. And this was her faith, represented by that candle there, the candle of baptism, the candle of the resurrection. And so we begin our Mass. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with each one of you. So gathering as we do, looking death in the face, but without fear, because we believe that death is not the end, that in the moment of death, God opens up the door to his heavenly home, to each and every one of us. And so we pray for healing and forgiveness within ourselves for the journey of life. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. And you are seated at the right hand of the Father. Lord, have mercy. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. And let us pray. O God, who are mercy for sinners and the happiness of your saints, give, we pray, to your servant Cora, for whom we perform the fraternal offices of burial, a share with your chosen ones in the blessedness you give, so that on the day of resurrection, freed from the bonds of mortality, she may come before your face, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. So we invite our readers now to come forward. You can just stay where you are. We'll get the mic down to you. We'll stay where you are. Yeah. Fun with us, the battery was gone down.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will prepare for all peoples a banquet of rich food. On this mountain, he will remove the mourning veil covering all peoples and the shroud enwrapping all nations. He will destroy death forever. The Lord will wipe away the tears from every cheek. He will take away his people's shames everywhere on earth. For the Lord has said so. That day it will be said, see, this is our God in whom we hoped for salvation. The Lord is the one in whom we hoped. We exult and we rejoice that he has saved us. This is the word of the Lord. From the second, a letter of St. Paul to Timothy. I am ready on the point of being sacrificed. The time of my departure has come. I have fought the good fight. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. Henceforth there is laid up for me the crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will award to me on that day, and not only to me, but also to all who have loved his appearing. This is the word of the Lord.
Gospel according to John. Mary, the sister of Lazarus, went to Jesus, and as soon as she saw him, she threw herself at his feet, saying, Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. At the sight of her tears and those of the Jews who followed her, Jesus said in great distress, with a sigh that came straight from the heart, "Where have you put him?" And they said, "Lord, come and see." Jesus wept. And the Jews said, "See how much he loved him." But there were some who remarked, "He opened the eyes of the blind man. Could he not have prevented this man's death?" Still sighing, Jesus reached the tomb. It was a cave with a stone that closed the opening. Jesus said, "Take the stone away." Martha said to him, "Lord, by now he will smell. This is the fourth day." And Jesus replied, "Have I not told you that if you believe, you will see the glory of God?" So they took away the stone. Then Jesus lifted up his eyes and said, "Father, I thank you for hearing my prayer. I knew indeed that you would always hear me, but I speak for the sake of those who stand around me, so that they may believe it was you who sent me." When he had said this, he cried in a loud voice, "Lazarus, here, come out." And the dead man came out, his feet and hands bound with bands of stuff and cloth around his face. Jesus said to them, "Unbind him, let him go free." And many of the Jews who had come to visit Mary and had seen what he did believed in him. The Gospel of the Lord. So please be seated as you are for a few moments. I chose this Gospel from Bethany because Bethany was the place that was, in a sense, Jesus' headquarters when he began to preach his ministry. And this house of Martha and Mary and Lazarus was the place where he stayed. It was like family to him. He could go back to that place and he could rest. He could go back to that place and no one would bother him. He could get back to that place and be taken care of himself. And so this became a place that was a home for him. And these people he grew to love very deeply, as we see from this story. And it was family that was at the center of Cora's life, as you well know. How she loved you, how she took care of you, how she gathered you to herself. Yesterday must have been difficult when we celebrated Mother's Day. And Mother's Day is, in a sense, a modern gift because when we were growing up, we didn't sort of have a day set aside, if you like, for saying thanks to our mothers, but at least that's there now. And we recognize in that day all the love that we feel and all the thanksgiving that we can raise in our hearts for everything that our mothers do for us. I think of standing here in this place where Cora would have come to pray. And I'm sure that every event in your lives that she prayed here for you, ask God to watch over you, ask God to protect you, ask God to bless you, ask God to be with you as you went through the different stages of your life. So in a sense, this was another home for her, a spiritual home where she talked to God and asked God's blessing over her family. But in very real and ordinary ways, taking care of you was what her life was all about. In all the small ways and all the ordinary things of keeping house, of going out to work, of cooking and cleaning and all the ordinary things. And in the midst of that, all of that represents one thing. She giving her life for each and every one of you. Pouring out her love, pouring out her life, pouring out all that her heart felt for each and every one of you. That's what we gather here to remember today. That's what we gather here to celebrate that today. All of that love and all of that caring. And in a great way, as I mentioned in the beginning, you're waiting for your dad, waiting for Philip to awaken so he could be part of the decisions that needed to be made around this time. It speaks of you honoring mother and father. It speaks of you loving them so much that you want them to be part of every moment of everything that's happening. And that's what's so important about this gospel, is this moment. And it's the only time in the gospel where we see Jesus shedding tears. And the Jews said, see how much he loved him. But it wasn't just that, because Jesus knew exactly what he was going to do. He was going to raise him up. And we are told that this is not a resurrection. It's some kind of resuscitation, because Lazarus would die again. But the most important thing about it is that this is Jesus weeping for Martha and Mary, who have lost their brother, who don't know what he's going to do, who don't know that this is a moment when he's going to be given back to them. Jesus is moved with sadness for those who are in mourning. And I think we need to hear that on a day like today, that when we cry, God cries. When we are hurt and wounded, God is hurt and wounded. That when we are lonely and sad, God is lonely and sad for us, and he cries for us. But the thing about his tears is they are tears that heal us. They're tears that renew us, tears that give us strength and courage. And that's one of the things you said about Korah, is that she had that strength of character, that when she decided to do something, nothing would stop her from doing that. She had that strength to follow through, to do what needed to be done. She had a strong mind and a strong character to achieve what needs to be done. And even in our taking Kathleen today to bury her ashes, this was one of the things she wanted to fulfill. This is one of the things she asked to be done, one of her final wishes, that this act of love of burying Kathleen. So even from beyond death, she is still achieving, she is still reaching out, she's still doing and completing what needs to be done. There's a writer called Henry Nouwen, and he was reflecting on his own mother's death. And I never tire of remembering this. He talked about his mother in the context of the communion of saints. He was saying that we talk to the saints as living people, not as dead people, because we expect them to respond to our prayer. So we believe they are alive. And he said, if this is true of these saints, he said, it's also true, he said, of my mother. So I will continue to talk to her. I will continue to pray to her. I will continue to ask her to be by my side. I will continue to ask her to be my wisdom and my guide in my life. And we can say that of Korah as well. That even though we will bury her body today, that the soul that was this woman, the life that was in this woman, is the very part of God that is inside in each one of us that never dies. It never dies. Henry Nouwen said, my mother may lie in the grave, but her soul will live on. And he said, a mother's work is never done until we are all home. Every mother knows what it is to wait, especially for the teenage children to come in, and they don't fall asleep until the last one is in, and you know that everyone is safe. I think there's a sense in which mothers don't rest in peace until we are all home, until we're all on the other side of death, moving into the new life. And so we give thanks for her life. We pray now that in all the efforts that you have made to make this what you wanted to be for her, to send her home to heaven, we ask God to reward you for that blessing and that love that you have shown. And we ask God to reward Korah and to bring her into the fullness and joy of his heavenly home. May she rest in peace. Amen. And so we turn to the prayers of the faithful now. God our Father has given us victory over sin and death through his Son, Jesus Christ. Let us turn to him in our hour of need and pray to him with confidence. In baptism, Korah was given the pledge of eternal life. May she now be admitted to the company of the saints. May God grant her full pardon of her sins. Lord, hear us. For Cora's family, that in these difficult and dark days, you may be sustained by faith and by the knowledge that we will all be reunited with Cora one day in God's heaven. Lord, hear us. For all our deceased relatives and friends, and we remember Kathleen this morning, and all your family members gone before, that God may bring them into the light of his presence and give them a share in his glory. Lord, hear us. For all here present and all who join us through the link as well, we are thinking of you and thank you for being with us in this way to pray for Cora today and to pray for her family. We pray the Lord's blessing on you and thank you for your support over these last days and months. Lord, hear us. We pray for all who are sick, and we think particularly of Philip today. We pray, Lord, that you help with the continuance of his recovery, that you give him strength and bring him health and healing again, and to be with him in this time of great sorrow for him. We think of all the sick, and we ask you, Lord, to bring blessing upon them on this day, your healing love to surround them. Lord, hear us. For all those kind neighbors and friends who have helped and supported you over this last month, and for all who work with the bereaved, we pray, Lord, you reward them. Lord, hear us. Father, into your hands we commend the soul of Cora. Look gently on her and bring her home to the kingdom where death is no more. We ask all of this through Christ our Lord. Amen. And you can be seated now as we prepare the gifts.
I pray you'll be my eyes and watch her where she goes, and help her to be wise. Help me to let go.
Sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord receive the sacrifice from your hands, the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his church. Be near, O Lord, we pray, to Cora, on whose funeral day we offer you the sacrifice of conciliation, so that should any stain or sin clung to her, or any human fault have affected her, it may, by your loving gift, be forgiven and wiped away. The Lord be with you, and lift up your hearts. and let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for you are faithful, Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with the angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. We kneel now for the Eucharistic prayer. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed, he entered willingly into his passion. He took bread, and giving thanks, he broke it. He gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more, giving thanks, he gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Don, our Bishop, and all the clergy. As we remember Cora, whom you have called today from this world to yourself, grant that she, who was united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. We remember Kathleen too today, and all the members of your family gone before. We remember all our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen, 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 amen.
And so we stand at the Saviour's command, and formed by divine teaching, and we dare to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. And the peace of the Lord be with you always. So just for a moment, in the silence of our heart, let us hold that gift of peace and pray the gift of eternal peace now for Cora. May this mingling of the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring eternal life to those who receive it. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. And so we kneel to prepare to receive the Lord. May the receiving of your body and blood, Lord Jesus Christ, not bring us to judgment or condemnation, but through your loving mercy be for us protection in mind and body and a healing remedy. And for those of you who join us who are not able to receive the Lord sacramentally today, we pray a spiritual communion for you as you unite yourself in this Mass with the Lord and with this family gathered in mourning. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. Only say the word, my soul shall be healed. Let perpetual light shine on Cora with your saints forever, for you are merciful. Eternal rest grant unto Cora, Lord. Let perpetual light shine upon her with your saints forever, for you are merciful. So for communion, if you just stay where you are, I'll come to you. If you'd just like a blessing today, you might just cross your arms before you.
It must have been cold there in my shadow, to never have sunlight on your face. You were content to let me shine, that's your way. You always walked a step behind. So I was the one with all the glory, while you were the one with all the strength. A beautiful face without a name for so long. A beautiful smile to hide the Did you ever know that you're my hero? You're everything I would like to be. I can fly higher than an eagle. have appeared to go unnoticed. But I've got it all here in my heart. I want you to know I know the truth. Of course I know it. I would be nothing without you. Did you ever know that you're my hero? You're everything I wish I could be. I could fly higher than an eagle. For you are the wind beneath my wings. For you are the wind beneath my wings.
Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body food for the journey, mercifully grant that strengthened by it, our sister Cora may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. You might be seated now, and just kind of a few words on behalf of the family.
Good morning, Reverend Father, ladies and gentlemen. We, the family of Cora, our dad Philip, sister Rita, Christopher, Philip Jr., Catherine, and Christina. Son-in-law John, daughter-in-law Helen, grandchildren Evan, Stuart, Shannon, and Leona, and nephew Pat Stuart, great-grandchildren Caden and Kinsley. We are sorry that our dad cannot be with us today due to illness. We would like to thank all you all very much for coming here today to celebrate the life of our mother Cora. Our mother was a great lady. She worked in St. John's Hospital for 25 years. We are able to have the life we had, all thanks to her hard work and determination. She loved nothing more than spoiling her grandchildren and great-grandchildren that she loved so much. She loved getting her hair done on a Friday, all styles. Then she would meet her really great friends for a coffee and a chat. Then on a Saturday with Christina, Leona, and I, to the shops till we dropped. We will miss you terrible, ma'am. You were a rock, always there when we needed you. It was a great privilege to have been your children. You gave us confidence to always know our self-worth, the strength to follow our dreams, and we knew and felt how deeply you loved us all. We would be forever grateful for having you in our lives. God bless you, and may you rest in peace.
Thank you, that was beautiful. So with those memories of all her love and her commitment to you and the way she gave her life for you, we stand for our final prayers. Before we go our separate ways, we take leave of Cora. We are farewell, express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet her again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. Now we honor Cora with the holy water and the incense, the holy water reminding us of the day of her baptism, when God made a promise to her that he would walk with her the journey of life, and that he would open the gates of heaven to her when that life was over. Then we honor her with the incense that reminds us of the sacredness of our bodies, that in these bodies the soul did live, and it was the soul that gave life to the body, the very part of God himself. And so she returns to the God who created her, the God who loves her and will continue to love her in eternity.
Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High.
Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High.
Saints of God, come to her aid, hasten to meet her, angels of the Lord.
Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High.
May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May the angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham.
Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High.
Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her.
Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High.
Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend Cora, in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings you bestowed on Cora in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to Cora, and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ, and we are with you and with Cora forever. In peace, we will take Cora to her place of rest. Eternal rest grant unto her, Lord. Let perpetual light shine upon her. May she rest in peace. May her soul and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. So thanks to Brendan and Eve for the beautiful music and singing that helped us through the ceremony. Thank you for the reading and the eulogy as well. Thank you so much for that. And to Jerry, to Crosses, for the way they help us through these times with professionalism, but with kindness too. So thanks for that.
Quando sono solo sogno l'orizzonte mancan le parole. Sì, lo so che non c'è luce in una stanza quando manca il sole. Se non ci sei tu con me su le finestre mostra il tuo. Dimmi il cuore che hai acceso, chiudi dentro me la luce che hai incontrato per strada.
It's time to say goodbye.